Hi, welcome to my channel Agri Entomology Tutors. If you are watching my channel for the first time, please subscribe the channel and click on the bell button to get all the notification of uploaded videos. Today we can start with insect morphology. In that, insect integument, structure, function, and along with helicoidal model which is proposed by Boligand in 1965. What is integument or exoskeleton? The insect body wall or external covering of the insect body is called as integument or exoskeleton. This exoskeleton is mainly of ectodermal in origin. This integument characteristics varies according to the insects which is adapted to that particular environment. This insect integument may be rigid, flexible, lighter or stronger in nature. This integument is mainly divided into three layers: epidermis, cuticle and basement layer. You can see here the first layer is basement layer, second layer is epidermis and the third layer consisting of cuticle. Now we can know the deep classification of this integument. This integument is classified into three layers: cuticle, non-cellular layer; epidermis, cellular layer; the basement membrane, non-cellular layer. Again, this cuticle is divided into two layers: epicuticle and procuticle. This procuticle is divided into again two layers: exocuticle and endocuticle. This endocuticle divided into mesocuticle and granular subcuticle. Then coming to the epicuticle, this epicuticle divided into four layers. Some scientists also says that five layers. The first layer is cement layer, second one is wax layer, third one is cuticulin layer, and the fourth one is inner epicuticle, and the fifth one is outer epicuticle. The first layer is a basement membrane, which is also called as basal lamina, which is a non-cellular layer. This basal lamina mainly form a continuous sheet below the epidermis. This thickness varies from 0.15 to 0.5 micrometer in length, and this basement membrane mainly produced by the epidermal cells or epidermis, which is a not biological membrane. This mainly consisting of a lipid monolayer or bilayer, which is of a negatively charged. The main function of this basement membrane is which acts as a molecular sieve. The chemically, this basement membrane consisting of fibrous protein, collagen, glycoprotein and glucosaminoglycans. The second layer is epidermis, which is a cellular layer of integument, mainly made up of a unicellular layer, which is resting on the basement membrane. The density of the epidermal cells varies from 3000 to 11000 per square millimeter. The main function of this epidermis are cuticle secretion, digestion and absorption of the old cuticle, especially of endocuticle, wound repairing, and which mainly gives a surface look. Some epidermal cells which are modified into seta. Here you can see the epidermis cell which is modified into a seta. This type of cells is called as trichogen cells. A socket forming cells which is present on the sides of this trichogen cells is called as tormogen cells. The study of arrangement of this seta is called as ketotaxy. This is mainly utilized in case of taxonomy, mainly in case of difference for species identification. Now coming to the third layer, cuticle, which is non-cellular layer consisting of the two layers. One is procuticle and another one is epicuticle. This procuticle is mainly divided into two layers based on their thickness. The outer layer is exocuticle and the inner layer is endocuticle. You can see here this whole part is called as cuticle. The outer layer is epicuticle and the whole inner layer is called as procuticle. This procuticle consisting of exocuticle and inner endocuticle. The exocuticle which look like a dark in color and which is highly stabilized as compared to the endocuticle, which is not digestible at the time of molting, and this exocuticle as a cast skin shed off during the process of molting. This exocuticle mainly composed of a chitin molecule and sclerotin. Hence, it looks dark in color and which is rigid as well as stabilized one. Now, coming to the endocuticle. This endocuticle is digestible by the molting fluid which is secreted at the time of molting process. And this endocuticle may or may not be pigmented one, which is of colorless, soft and flexible, as because it is mainly composed of chitin and arthropodin, not like a sclerotin. As compared to the exocuticle, the endocuticle is the innermost layer as well as the thickest layer of procuticle. When we look this endocuticle under the light microscope with the polarized filters, this endocuticle seems to be composed of successive light as well as dark layers, which mainly corresponding to the daily growth of their layers. This dark layer are deposited mainly during the daytime, and the light layers are deposited at the time of night. Again, these light layers are mainly divided into alternating layer of light and dark lamellas. Many models were developed to explain the lamella and striation. One such model is helicoidal model, which is proposed by Boligand in 1965. This model mainly explained about the parabolic patterning and described in helicoidal architecture, mainly to represent the way in which the chitin microfibrils are organized in a protein matrix. According to this model, the microfibrils which are secreted, which are arranged in parallel in each plane, and along with these planes which are also parallel to the cuticle surface. In successive planes, the direction of orientation of the microfibrils rotates through a small angle, always in one direction of rotation. You can see here the microfibrils are secreted, which are parallel to the parallel to each other within the plane, and which are also parallel to the layers secreted during the different time. You can see here each layers which are parallel to the each other, as well as this whole secretion of microfibrils layers which are parallel to the cuticle, along with a small angle of change can be noticed in each successive layers. You can see here the helicoidal arrangement of the chitin layers when they rotated at a small constant angle during their synthesis. As the microfibrils are laid down in a layered sheet, within each sheet the microfibrils are parallel to each other. But in successive sheets, they are alighted at regular changing angles. This arrangement would account for the parabolic patterning of the endocuticle. Here you can see, this is the same picture of this helicoidal arrangement of the chitin layers or chitin microfibrils, in which a ribbon shaped pore canal is embedded. When we took transfer section at a different time, this pore canal shape will be varied from one section to the another section. by this we can confirm that different plane of this microfibrils or chitin layers which is rotating. Here you can see the pore canals. These pore canals are twisted in a helicoidal manner or in a ribbon like manner, as because these pore canals are pass through these microfibrils or microfibers. As because of this successive layer twisting happens, this pore canal also twisted in a helicoidal manner. In addition to the exo and endocuticle, the procuticular layers has been identified based on their staining reactions. One is mesocuticle and the second one is granular subcuticle. This mesocuticle mainly lies between the exocuticle and endocuticle, and the subcuticle is a newly secreted form of endocuticle which is not yet reached its final structural configuration. Now coming to the outermost layer called as epicuticle. This epicuticle is very thin and mainly divided of chitin molecules. The pore canals which are present in the exocuticle region, which mainly helps in the deposition of this epicuticle. Here you can see the pore canals which are present in the exocuticle. These are the pore canals present in the exocuticle. This epicuticle mainly divided into five important layers. The first one is cement layer, which is also called as tectocuticle, which is of less than 0.1 micrometer in thickness. And the second one is a wax layer. Third one is cuticulin layer, which is also called as protein layer, consisting of non-chitinous polymerized lipoprotein, is of 100 to 200 Armstrong in thickness. The fourth one is inner epicuticle and the fifth one is outer epicuticle. This outer epicuticle mainly helps in contact with the cuticulin layer. You can see here the outermost layer of this epicuticle is a cement layer. Outermost layer of this cuticle is epicuticle, and the chitin molecules are absent in epicuticle. Inner epicuticle. This inner epicuticle mainly of about 0.1 micrometer in their thickness. This mainly limits the expansion of the cuticle in between the successive molds. This pore canals which are terminate beneath in this layer. You can see here the pore canals which are terminate beneath this inner epicuticle layer. But the dermal gland canals communicate with the surface of the cuticle. The last two layers of this epicuticle is cement layer and the wax layer. This cement layer mainly secreted by the dermal glands, which is similar to the shellac. This cement layer mainly formed by the lipid and tannin protein mainly protects the wax layer. This cement layer mainly decides the surface property of the cuticle, whether it is hydrophobic or hydrophilic. This cement layer also serves as a protective barrier and also contains some of the antifungal components. When comes to the wax layer, it mainly consisting of a single layer of a lipid or a mono layer of lipid, which is directly associated with the cuticulin layer. This wax layer mainly responsible for the permeability characteristics of the cuticle, but this cement layer mainly responsible for the surface property of the cuticle. This wax layer mainly consisting of a closely packed wax molecules which prevents the desiccation of water from the body. At last comes to the function of the body wall. This body wall mainly gives protection to the insect from the predators and parasites and also from the physical environment. For example, in case of the coleoptera, which consisting of the hard exoskeleton or the hard elytral structure, this mainly helps to get protected from the predators. It helps in reducing the water loss, as because the wax layer which is present in the epicuticle part, which avoids the water loss or desiccation from the insect body, acts as a this body wall acts as a supporting structure to complete body of the insect, and also it imparts the shape to the insect body. This cuticle part is also invaginated inside the body of the insect to give a internal support as well as a structure. It gives a structure for muscle attachment. Some parts of the cuticle are also modified to form a sense organ. Thereby, it helps in sensing the environmental change. This body wall gives a physical structure to the cuticle and also imparts a production of the colors to the body. Hope the video was helpful. Please like, share, and subscribe the channel. Thank you.